What are some of the best bits about your life, Paul?
Wow, what a question. So that's a really good question. Some of the best bits about my life.
Yeah. What are the best aspects?
Oh, wow. Best aspects of my life, without a doubt, is having a gorgeous wife and two gorgeous children. That's really easy.
What's important in my life? I don't know, I think it's important for everybody to think about what's important in their life and do it, do you know what I mean? I think there's so much noise and background information, you know, people listening to stuff on the radio, on the internet, and, you know, do we really think about what's important? I don't know.
I think it's really important for people to think about what it is they want to do that makes them happy, you know?
So that makes you happy to think about what it is that's important to you, that gives you clarity in your own life?
Yeah, well, you only get one life, don't you? So you may as well be doing what makes you happy. Otherwise, what are you doing?
So why do you do the things you do, Paul?
I do the things I do because I want to and I can, and I find them much more interesting than working and doing what other people tell me to. It's nice to do things that other people tell me to, but it's nice to do your own thing.
And what you think it's been an important thing for you to do this for your film? Has it improved your life being a filmmaker?
Yeah, of course. You know, I mean, today, for example, I get to go up to Oxfam and meet some really interesting people, find out what they've been doing, and I'm going to learn some stuff. Well, I always think that, you know, making films, taking video, photographing people, being active in that way, it gives you a chance to go and meet new people and find out what they're doing. And I always think of it as like, kind of like dancing in between the shadows. We can go in between all of the gaps that people don't normally go down, you know? Okay, yeah. We can sort of go up to people and ask them something that you wouldn't ordinarily ask.
With the question, what should I do with my life? What does that make you think about?
I think the question, what should you do with your life, is probably the most profound question you can actually ask. And because it gets to down to why are we here, what's the point of it, you know, why should we, you know, we have to engage with the world, it's around us, so maybe it's a really good question to really ask what we should be doing, you know, rather than just getting on and doing something, because we think that's what we should do, and we're sort of programmed and told and led to think this way and do this thing. Maybe we should really question that. Think, well, what should you do with your life? I think the most obvious answer is you should do what makes you happy. Surely, because you're doing it all the time anyway, so you may as well do something that really makes you happy.
If you ask questions about the world, you learn, don't you? And if you learn, yeah, life is about learning, isn't it? I mean, every single day you're learning something new. So, you know, it's about, I think, getting more active in that process of actually asking and learning. You know, the more you ask, the more you learn. The more you learn, the more you want to ask. You know, you don't, certainly as you get older, you don't have less questions in life. You have a lot more. And maybe those questions are more profound and take more questions again to start answering. I mean, the thing with me, I'm really lucky in the fact that I knew that I wanted to do photography when I was 4 years old. You know, I was making little Lego cameras. I had a dark room at the age of 12. You know, it's what I do and it's what I love doing. So, you know, I think I got an amazing gift that was given to me to do photography and do video, so I feel really lucky about that. But yeah, I mean, what makes me happy is working behind cameras, making videos, making positive films that hopefully say something about society. I just looked out in the world, I see what I see on the TV, I see what I see when I see people out in society, and I just thought, do you know what, I think we can do better. I think that, you know, the way that we quite happily go out and spend £10 billion on nuclear missiles, you know, we can do better than that. We don't have to do that. You know, the way the banking system is so skewed to the rich people, again, we can do better than that. You know, so I just thought I'd like to go out and look at some of these issues, because I've got children and they're really special and really important. We want life, with our eyes wide open.
with Buddha down there, it's probably quite fitting just to say that I don't think you have to fill your life with everything all the time. You know, people think, I've got to fill this time and do something with it. Do you know what? I just think sometimes it's okay to not do anything and to actually be. I think we forget that. Actually, if you run through your life filling it up with stuff all the time, when do you get a chance to really sit and reflect about what it is, what your life is about, or what being here on this planet is about? You know what I mean? That was the end of the story.